of all, can I ask Michael Simpson, who looked at the work and chose the work, to tell us a little bit about it?
Thank you very much. Hello, everybody. My name is Michael Simpson. I'm Director of Visual Arts at the Lowry, just up the road. I was absolutely delighted. Many, many thanks for inviting me to select the exhibition this year, working with Amy Goodwin. It's an absolute pleasure to support a club with such a fine history and such a consistent approach to making sure that art is made in Salford and shown in Salford. And of course, you'll understand that LS Lowry is very important to myself and to the Lowry itself, and LS Lowry had a strong relationship with the art club. So it's particularly pleasing for me to work with Salford Art Club on this. You seem to focus on giving everybody high quality opportunities to draw and paint and make and exhibit art in Salford, and that is incredibly important. And I have to say that the partnership with Salford Art Gallery is so enlightened and has been so consistent over the years. These things are always, I know for the museum side of things, these things are always things that you can never take for granted. So the relationship over the years, and John Scully's been a huge part of that, is another thing that makes the art club so absolutely special. I've been very lucky over the years to judge a few art club exhibitions, but I have to say, and this is the absolute truth, this was the most organised, the most efficient, the fairest judging selection process I've ever been involved in. And I can assure you, and I don't think you'll need assurance, but I can assure you that Pam Kirk and the rest of the team, and Amy and the team here, work so exceptionally hard to make sure that it is as fair a process as it can possibly be. And it's backbreaking for a start, because there's lots of moving pictures around. Poor old Pam, we were doing things in the wrong order, so she's having to keep up with the pieces of paper and things like that. It's a real task to get it right, but it was easily the best organised I've ever been involved in. And of course it's a blind judging, so I didn't know whose work was whose, so Amy and myself were able to, I really like this one, let's go for this one, and it was a really enjoyable, creative process. What was I personally looking for? Personally, yes, of course I'm looking for skills. Yes, I'm looking for an artist with a bit of an eye, but, I promise I'm not going to go on too long, because I did speak last year, and you'll have heard most of what I'm saying already last year, but what's really important to me is that I look at a work of art that makes me feel something, whether it makes me feel as if I want to be in that place, or if I can be in that moment, or if there's an emotional connection to it. Again, forgive me if you've heard me say this quote before, because it is my favourite quote, but L.S. Lowry said, you don't need brains to be an artist, just feelings. And for me, that sums absolutely everything up. So that's what I was looking for primarily when I was doing the selection. What gave me a connection to it? What set me thinking and so on? And I always like artists who are prepared to take a few risks, lay themselves bare a little bit, or try and have a different perspective on things. Don't get me wrong, I love classic landscape painting, still life painting, portraiture. It's always exciting when someone's going to just push themselves out of that comfort zone. So I hope some of that was rewarded in the selection. Selecting itself is a bit nerve-wracking. Don't feel sorry for me or for Amy, but it is a bit nerve-wracking actually, because there's an implied a kind of level of criticism really about what's good and what's not. And I'm with Noel Coward, who said, I love criticism just so long as it's unqualified praise. So it's good to work on. And of course, the more I thought about it, I thought, well, you as artists are selecting all the time. When you're painting a landscape, you're selecting what bits of that landscape you include and what you exclude, because the aim is to get the best possible composition. So as we selected for this exhibition, we wanted to reward and to acknowledge the best that was in the submissions, but we also wanted to put together a great exhibition. And I have to say, I think Amy and the team have done a fantastic job. It's it's a hard job to take such a disparate amount of disparate sorts of works and then turn it into a coherent exhibition. And this, I think, looks absolutely fantastic. So that's all I'm going to say, because I really want to hear Jeffrey and John speak. But I just wanted to say again, once again, many thanks for inviting me to do it. Thank you very much.